Today, an Australian man gets thrown off an online dating website for telling the truth.
Find out if you are a bromosexual.
And what do tranny granny, Parisian heist robbery victim, and Foxy Megan's bloody tampon have in common? You don't want to know, but we're going to talk about it on The Point. Welcome to The Point, the only talk show bringing gay and straight men together to see what happens. Today, Jesse is back with us.
Yeah.
Jesse Hazen.
Ooh, Jesse.
Looking like a golden goddess.
Yes.
Yeah, I'm so underdressed compared to this. Yeah. I wore a Superman shirt, like, it's Halloween-y coming up, so I'll wear a Superman shirt. And then fucking this shows up. Like a goddess, and I'm just like, oh, goddess.
And you've got like your Halloween hat here.
Popping like a pumpkin.
Hashtag.
Pineapple is like a little child. Instead of jack o' lanterns, it's like you carve out a pineapple.
Really?
Instead of a pumpkin.
Really?
Yeah.
I've never heard of
that. It's a new craze. Yeah, it looks wicked.
Wow. Too. Well, I didn't have anything Halloween-y to wear, so I actually got the scariest thing that I own, which is my Michael Jackson doll.
Oh my god. It's amazing. Why do you own this?
Wow.
Why has that not been our mascot from day one?
Okay, can we talk about his nose, though?
I don't want to talk about it at all.
That's ignorant. That's ignorant.
Right?
Wait.
Can that just like stay here forever?
Yes. Gordon's having a hard time with this right now.
Blanket.
Okay. There, here. Right next to you.
No, I don't want to go anywhere.
Okay. There you go. All right. What are you doing? All right. No. Okay. The New York Times actually had... Are you hiding, Mike? Where is Michael? What is he doing?
Let us remember...
He's sleeping.
What is he doing
Michael.
Down there?
Brother Michael. I like that Michael a lot better.
The New York Times actually had a very interesting article recently about what they called bromosexual friendships. And it struck me because it's kind of like what we're doing. You know, the whole genesis...
You mean after we stop taping?
Yes. Then we're all bromosexual together. No, the whole idea of that gay men and straight men don't have a history of being friends and getting along the way gay men and straight women do. But the article in the Times was talking about how it's becoming a thing now. So it's beyond the bromance, you know, where it's like two straight guys, where this is a gay guy and a straight guy having a strong friendship bond. And I just wondered, do you have other gay men that you
honestly
hang out with as friends?
I love gay men. It's really bad.
And gay men love you.
Thank you.
Right,
but no, I just find like overall, gay people in general are just more confident people and more comfortable with themselves and how they are, and it's just very, it's good to be around because it kind of brings out this other part of you maybe that you're afraid to show or whatever. You know what I mean?
Wow.
You're just able to be yourself. That's what I find.
And Gordon, so I think we are the first gay people he's actually ever met.
Oh yeah.
Yeah, I had a boss by the name of Michael.
That Michael.
All right, leave it alone. but other than that, yeah, you know, you guys are just my first experience.
We are your first experience.
Wow. This is Gordon experimenting with
you know, I wanted to take my time with the phrase, but I was like, fuck it.
I'm going to
do something with it.
Now, you are a big show queen. Show queen.
Show queen.
That's exactly how I
put it. You're a straight guy, but you love the show tunes.
I do, actually. My friend Brad will often come over and we'll work on things. Brad is the associate producer on the show, Brad McDermott. And... I always make sure to have a little, like, music theater education session for him. So he'll come over and we'll be editing, one of his films or something like that. and I'll sort of be like, all right, now we're going to watch some clips from Next to Normal, or we're going to whatever. Now tell me the difference between these two performances, or have you heard from this show? And he, you know, I'm sure he hates it, but I'm like, well, if you want me to work on your stuff, you're going to have to put up with me. Because I just love this musical theater.
It's like blackmail.
The last time I was at your house, it was Hamilton. Mm-hmm. It was all Hamilton.
How did this start? Like, how did you start loving that?
Honestly, I was 8 years old, and my brother wanted to go see the show Miss Saigon here in Toronto back when it was, like, they built the Princess of Wales Theater for that show. Oh. And my parents couldn't leave me at home, so they took me with them. And I was just this kid, and seeing all this crazy stuff on stage that I didn't know you could ever do, like... I mean, you know, these girls in bikinis at the beginning and this, like, full-size army helicopter mm-hmm. and these army guys with guns and these big sets. And it was so crazy and so incredible. And then just I got attached to this idea of telling stories through music. And it's just something that I've had a passion for ever since. And I just absolutely love it. That's why a couple of years ago I directed a production of The Last 5 Years, the musical The Last 5 Years at the Winchester Street Theater there, you know?
That's
like,
really cool.
It's something that I've always loved and want to do more of, and yeah.
That's so gay of you.
It is, but...
I actually had that with Joseph in the Amazing Technicolor Dreamcoat. I saw that when I was like 7 or 8 years old, yeah. And I was like, this is incredible.
Mm-hmm. You know, I went to see Joseph and the Amazing Technicolor, Joseph, when I was in high school, and, well, never mind, I'm going to date myself here, because I grew up in New York, and so it was like a thing that like, oh, let's go see a Broadway play after school, and of course, like,
God, I'd love that.
That's not,
is that a thing?
That's like, or like during the summer, it's like, oh, we can go see a matinee of Dreamgirls.
That's so cool, though.
I know. And yeah, David Cassidy, who was Keith Partridge in the Partridge Family, was
Nobody knows any of those things.
Gordon
has never met any of those things.
Never ask a lady her age.
No. Okay, no, but this was interesting. In the Times article, it quotes a gay man saying, friendships with straight men can be very healing. When you experience a close friendship with a straight guy and that person is accepting, it's a balm for old wounds. Do you find that to be the case? Like when you befriend straight men?
I don't
that
really
they're
befriend straight men. Well, I honestly,
thanks, Tito.
I find it intimidating to ever even try to become close with a straight guy because, you know, like, it's so normal for everyone to say, oh, they're just going to think that you're hitting on them, right. That type of thing. So
well, that's
scary.
Actually, that's part of the reason why, according to this article, a lot of gay men are hesitant to befriend mm-hmm. straight men because they're afraid the straight man will think they're hitting on them.
Yeah.
But straight guys complain, to gay men, you can just meet a guy and go home and have sex.
Yeah, but that's not cool. That's not what we'll
love. Wait, no,
what
and I've heard this before.
Yeah.
That
what you want is straight, like it's not about what you want though. It's a different thing. Like it's not like yeah, everybody wants different things. Like there are people who want to sleep around. There are people who are looking for a more committed relationship. There are people whatever. But I think the argument here is that it's just it's easier to approach and
gay men can talk to hook up. Okay, let's go. Whereas straight male friends of
This is so educational for me.
No.
This is
so
there you go.
So Grindr is like Tinder, but it's...
I know the basis of it.
Yeah,
but
is it easier?
Yeah, it is.
Oh, well.
Because like we get
straight to the point.
I feel like 2016, it's pretty much easy across the board now. Yeah. Like, I mean, with all these Tinder stuff and everything, like, I think when Grindr was first starting, it would have been easier for gay boys to just like kind of like hook up and do their stuff, but... I have a lot of girlfriends, and they get the D whenever they want to get it. I mean, it's easy now.
Me.
Well, you guys, I thought you had a girlfriend.
What? Who?
Did you have a girlfriend?
Okay, but why are we talking about that now?
Because you said, like, you're talking about me.
Like, last year, or, like... Man.
You weren't playing your cards right.
So some gay men actually express jealousy over certain aspects of heterosexual male presentation. This is a quote from the guy. Straight guys can let themselves go and no one cares. Gay men are judging each other worse than women in terms of body shaming.
Yeah.
It's like that line, one of my all-time favorite lines of, I can't. I have to go to the gym. I'm gay fat. I'm straight thin, but I'm gay fat. Like, you know, it's a very different metric.
Oh, yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
So
I've never heard that before
in my life.
Oh no, like beside you here, he's all like ripped and thin and everything. I'm like, I'm a whale beside him. Like, put me But that's the mentality.
That's exactly what I'm talking about. Because you're not a whale.
What does that have to do with homosexuality?
If I don't have a six pack in the gay world, I'm fat. That's how it is.
But don't you, I actually find that even among straight men, I mean, the use of steroids and the emphasis on how you look, you know, they used to call them metrosexuals, right? The straight guys who, like, you know, wear shirts like this.
They just, like, took care of themselves.
But they fill them up, right?
Thanks, Fred.
No, but you were
oh, man.
It's more acceptable.
Bromance. Bromosexual. But you were talking about Tinder and Grindr and all that. Okay, so an Australian man went on Plenty of Fish, and he put in his profile that he would not date.
Sorry, I'm like, it still exists?
Plenty of Fish?
Yeah,
I guess.
There are still plenty of fish.
So the guy put in his profile he would not date a woman over 30, and he would not date a woman who was overweight. And the internet exploded.
Unlike the internet.
calling the guy a creep, an asshole, blah, blah, blah.
Okay.
Really?
And Plenty of Fish actually threw him off.
Oh.
That's so dumb.
That is so dumb.
That's so dumb.
I mean, everyone is going to blame it on their preference. And, like, I mean, you can put whatever you want in your profile. People don't have to respond.
I feel like the reality is most of the time, that's the mentality of anyone who is online dating. Like, you're going to judge someone based on pictures, based on, you know what I mean? Like, it's, which is the same as in real life, you know, you see someone, that's your first connection, your first attraction. And so this guy was just kind of dumb and just actually said it out loud or wrote it on a profile instead of just not saying it but thinking it like everyone else on the internet.
Actually, a little correction. It wasn't in his profile. No. Sorry about that. He replied to a woman who replied to his ad, and he said, "Oh, I won't date you because you're over 30."
So he basically said no.
So that changes everything.
What?
Does
it change everything?
It does.
Okay, so because he could have been just... Okay, so if you put it out there for the world to see, so let's say you say, like, I don't do femmes, I don't do this, I don't do that. Okay, whatever. If I read it, I won't reply to you. That's okay. That's cool. But if I reply to you, just politely say, I'm not interested, and I'm okay with that.
But either way...
Or just ignore the message and ghost like everyone does.
I know that. But what I find interesting about this story is that he was, at some point, upfront about, like, you know, you're too old for me or you're overweight. Like... You go on Grindr, and there's so much, like, I'm not saying it's right, but there's so much, you know, a straight acting and appearing, no fats, no femmes. I'm not condoning that.
But you
ignore them. But even if somebody says, if you go on and somebody says, oh, you know, you're older than I thought you were, or whatever, you just... Ignore. You don't go on. No. Do you shame them on the internet?
Honestly, no, but that's just douchey. Just say, I'm not interested. Good luck with your search. Like, you don't have to say, I don't like it because you're fat. That's bullying now. Just say, I'm not interested. And then that's okay. Yeah. You're cool. And if you're man or girl enough to accept it, you're okay. You can move on. But don't start pinpointing what's wrong with a person, because what you think is wrong with that person might not be something I think is wrong with me.
No,
you know I mean?
Absolutely. I agree. But should he have
gotten kicked off for a private message that he sent someone.
No.
But there was all this stuff about him. And then he had to respond back about why he doesn't want to date over 30. And it has to do with because he wants kids and the gene pool. And
just join Tinder. POS. F is so out of date. Just on Tinder. You won't get kicked off. It's so easy.
But he wants a wife.
You can find a wife on Tinder.
I don't think
you can. So many people have gotten married on Tinder.
Have, I don't necessarily agree with it because I hate Tinder, but I mean, like, people have found love on Tinder. Yeah. I've heard of it. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. But is it like, I guess that's something you fall into.
Found
like,
love on Tinder.
You fall into it. I don't think you're like looking for, I'm looking for a love.
I'm not on those
apps. One love. I'm looking for one love.
A love. What's the difference?
A love? One love?
One love.
No, but I'm on those apps. I'm not looking to
hook up. How many loves are you looking for, Jesse?
Just one. Just one.
Yeah. Big love.
I want, like, a loving husband. Really? Like, where are you? Hi. You're watching. Call me.
While Jesse goes on Tinder, it's time for Tigo's Midpoint.
All right, so this week we're playing a little play off of Pinpoint. It's the Halloween edition. So I'm going to have some celebrities dressed up in Halloween costumes, and everyone has to guess who they think it is.
Who the celebrity is.
Who the celebrity is, yeah.
Not who the costume is.
No. No, I'll talk about the costume and you guys can. So this is a celebrity dressed up as Miley from her video back in the day.
Is it Miley Cyrus?
No, it's not Miley dressed up as.
Oh, yes. That was gonna be my guess.
Paris Hilton.
Definitely Paris Hilton.
And that also is Paris Hilton.
Oh, okay.
That is her.
Oh, okay, that's the reveal.
Oh, I see.
That's uncovered. It's the uncensored version.
Okay.
All right. So next we have.
Show me.
Gwen Stefani.
This was very controversial.
No, that's Julianne Hough or Ho. Whatever.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Julianne
what?
Hough and her
that.
Very
controversial.
Huff.
No, Huff. I don't know her last name.
Jesus. I thought it was the girl from Die Antwoord.
No, she was in that Juicy Fruit commercial.
No, and I felt so bad for the girl because I'm like, I didn't think there was anything.
Huff. So she dressed up as Crazy Eyes from Orange is the New Black, and it was super controversial.
Why
was
that?
Because she painted it black.
Oh, did she do that?
It's bronze.
Well, it's bronzer. I mean, my face is covered in bronzer.
Here. This is blackface.
Like, I don't think.
Oh.
She just, she bronzed her face up a bit. And
what do you think about that?
I mean, don't do
How
that.
How do you feel about people
don't do that?
Doing don't do that. Because I saw like a blonde girl and she was Kodak Black, who is a black rapper. You know, have you seen Kodak Black?
No.
What?
Yeah, he's just like a black rapper. He has like the little bumps. I don't know if you guys know.
And you think that's okay then?
Yeah, it's okay. Just don't do the blackface because we know who you are. Like she did it.
Oh, she did.
We knew exactly who
for her to be. For her to be Crazy Eyes, just don't do the bronze.
Yeah, because we know who she is.
Exactly. The costume and the hair is fine.
That was the main argument.
Yeah.
Was like,
yeah, but if she would have kept the white face, I would have thought she was a freaking Teletubby.
No, because she has the jail suit on.
Whatever.
So you knew.
Okay.
Next. All right. So here we have a male dressed up as the Hamburglar.
Oh, yeah. Okay.
Is it a Jonas Brother?
It is a Jonas Brother.
Which one?
I don't know.
Nick.
Joe.
I can't even see.
Nick.
Devin.
Nick the one?
I don't know who the Jonas Brother's name
is. Sean?
The other one doesn't exist.
It's not Kevin.
It's not Kevin.
It's not Kevin Jonas.
Nick.
Is Nick the one that's out right now? Because if it is, then it's Nick.
It's Nick.
If that's Nick, he needs less clothing.
You love
Nick. We love
it's
Nick.
It's not any more clear.
I would be
from the reveal.
I would be in a bromosexual.
He does love the gays. He actually
loves the gays, and he's dipped his little toes in there.
Oh, has he?
How do you know that?
Celebrity watcher.
We will talk about this offline.
Inside
off the record.
All right, next. So this girl went as a trap queen.
That's Demi Lovato.
God damn it, let me finish.
I love her.
Wow.
The trap queen. So cute, I love her outfit.
Trap
has little,
queen?
Little traps. No, like the song, Fetty Wap.
Do you know what a trap queen is?
Like I know Fetty Wap songs.
Trap king, like adjacent.
Anyway, yes, it's Demi Lovato.
All right.
She's so gorgeous.
Next, we have somebody dressed up as Nicki Minaj.
Kesha.
No.
Oh, no, no.
That's Ellen DeGeneres. Hello,
oh,
people.
It is.
It is?
Oh.
Yes. She's so pretty with long hair. Ellen, if you're watching, let your hair grow.
I was going to say Sarah Jessica Parker.
Also, Ellen, if you're watching, please retweet and share this show.
Yes.
She's so sexy with big boobs.
Anyways. So this celebrity went as a big ass Cheeto.
How are we supposed to
Because
it's
Nick
an iconic outfit. Iconic.
It must be Sia. She never shows her face.
Kim Kardashian.
No.
No, that's too much clothing for Kim.
Nobody knows this iconic outfit from
iconic.
I want Cheetos now.
Okay, it's.
How is this iconic?
It's Katy Perry.
Oh, can I see?
I do like Katy Perry.
Oh, she's pretty. She got big boobs too.
I thought maybe it was Madonna.
Nothing's Madonna.
Nothing. I hate.
No, don't you be.
Did you say that you hate Madonna?
I think that's the reveal picture.
Yes.
No!
I don't like Madonna.
No, okay, next. Not now.
okay, sorry.
John Goodman.
Next. See, I don't even have to cover anything because these prosthetics are on point.
Stacy Keach.
Chris Christie.
I don't know.
I was gonna say John.
This is Fiona. This is like the Shrek. But it's a male. It's not a female.
Yeah.
I'm gonna stick with Stacey Keach because it's hilarious to say Stacey Keach.
Doesn't even look
that is funny.
No.
And we're the only ones who know who that is.
No one knows who that is.
Okay.
Okay, it's Colton Haynes.
I don't know who that is.
He's so hot.
I don't know who that is.
Colton Haynes. He's an actor. He just came out.
He's gay, right?
Yeah, he just came out.
Okay,
really
one more.
Give
us one more.
This is the last one.
Okay.
My fave.
Ooh, I like the costume.
Can I see?
Jessica.
Oh, that's Brown. Heidi Klum.
Yeah, sorry.
Oh, I was going to say Melania.
She's so hot.
So Heidi went goes all out every year, and this is another prosthetic type outfit.
Wow, so it looks like one thing.
Yeah.
The thing being her body.
And it looks like
it's just it's all prosthetic. It. Like, great. It's all fake, and yeah, she looks amazing.
That's fun.
Imagine, she probably was crazy. In, like, hair and makeup for at least 12, 13 hours. For like, sure. That's so crazy.
Yeah.
That's cool. Crazy. That's it. Well, thank you, Tito, for your midpoint.
Yeah.
Nice.
Does anybody actually have any costumes that they're wearing? Any plans for costumes?
I kind of want to do the kid, I forget his name, from Stranger Things. No teeth.
11?
Everyone's doing Stranger Things. Yeah, it's not, I don't know.
I always go like super lame. Like I do like the Ralph Wiggum Idaho costume, which just says Idaho, a piece of paper, I just stick it in my gun. But apparently everyone at my office is like crazy into Halloween, like it's a big ordeal, so I actually need to put some effort into it, so I need some suggestions.
Well, I have some bad suggestions.
Wait, I didn't talk about mine.
Oh, sorry.
Wait, does anyone else, Gordon, are you
no.
doing anything? No?
I was okay, so
good thing we took time.
Gordon hates Halloween.
I was Kim Kardashian a few Halloweens ago, and like for me to top that off is impossible because like my really good friend Roger Medina, he's a celebrity hair and makeup artist, he like did me up and I looked like Kim K. Like I was walking down the streets on Front and King Street in Toronto and like people were stopping and trying to take selfies and I was like, but my butt ain't that big, so it's not me. But yeah, so it's hard to like top that off, so we'll see. Maybe it'll be like Chloe this year.
Yeah, do it.
Yeah.
You need you need the hips.
No, she lost a lot of weight, so I'm going to have to stop eating pizza.
Okay.
I don't mess with ghosts, nor do I mess with ghouls.
I was going to be a sexy Pokemon trainer, but I think I'm going to go with sexy male Maleficent.
Ooh.
Maleficent.
Maleficent. That's
odd.
So I'm trying to figure that out, but I think that's...
You'll have to bring us pictures for next time.
So if you want to see me half naked, just follow me on Instagram.
That's right.
That has nothing to do with Halloween. That's a separate plug entirely.
Actually, that's kind of true.
A little true.
Kind of true. Okay, bad Halloween costumes. Okay, this caught my attention because Amazon, Walmart, and Target ended up pulling a costume that came out called Tranny Granny, which, hopefully we can get a picture up of that. So there was outrage about it, specifically the use of the word tranny. So Amazon, Walmart, and Target pulled it off the shelf. Then the same costume company that has done sort of offensive costumes in the past has come out with the Parisian heist robbery victim, which is a take on Kim Kardashian being bound and gagged and all that.
That is so disgusting.
We talked about last week.
Yeah.
And this comes after last year, there was a lot of complaints about the Caitlyn Jenner.
When I saw that in store, the Caitlyn Jenner cover for Vanity Fair, I was like, who the fuck comes up with this shit? It's so disrespectful.
It's genius.
Okay.
It kind of
To me, the worst one was Foxy Megan's Bloody Tampon, and that was a take on Megyn Kelly, the Fox News anchor, who in a debate, during a Republican debate, Donald Trump supposedly made her angry. And so he said afterwards, she had blood coming out of her eyes, blood coming out of her wherever. Then my question goes to what you two are saying, which is it offensive or is it funny and genius?
It's so funny and genius. People need to chill.
Were they selling the last one? Because the last one's kind of a deep cut.
The all
like, I don't know what is that?
There's a joke in there that I'm not going to go to.
Well done, sir.
Hashtag.
Okay. Yeah, leave it alone, guys.
Deep cut.
Leave it alone.
But last year, that was a lot in the news. So, you know, especially if you were paying attention. So, yeah. So, is it just blanket offensive?
Well, the question is it offensive for them to make it, or is it offensive for you to be the piece of shit who buys it? You know what
I'll
I mean? Like,
to make it available.
Is that the problem? Because some of them, I mean, like, this tampon thing, like, that's, like, what are you doing? You know what I mean? Like, that's not, like, a big cultural, like,
who wants to go
milestone,
like,
whatever. It's not. It's just a comment from some idiot who was running for president. But you know what I mean? Like, it's not... Like, I at least understand why they would do the Caitlyn Jenner. You know what I mean? Like, it's...
So why is that one okay and the other one's not okay?
I'm not saying it's okay. I'm just saying I get why they would do it because it was such a big part of society, and there is an actual look to it. You know what I mean? Like, it is a person that you are trying to become.
I mean, the costume, and we saw it together, and because they had the Caitlyn one and then the Bruce Jenner one.
When I saw that.
No, you were, but I actually thought, because it's just like the bustier or whatever
that
she
was wearing. Yeah,
it's
just a top and bottom. It's like, how do you distinguish that from any other person wearing a top and bottom?
And the wig. Mm. I mean, you liked the word iconic. That, a Vanity Fair cover, was iconic.
It was.
Yeah.
And so to dress up as that, as long as
it's... Yeah, but you're making fun of her. You're not.
Are you not? I think you can. I think if the wrong person wore it, it would be.
Anyone who's buying that is making fun of her.
No, if I did that, it wouldn't necessarily be making fun.
You dressed as Kim Kardashian. Is that making fun of
her? No, for me, it's like, I don't know. Like, people just need to grow the fuck up. And, like,
well, Kaylin's a joke in itself, so... I would feel like it was insulting.
But, you know, something with this idea of intent, right? Like, maybe if you intend to do it because you're a garbage person who wants to, you know, slander transgender people, then that's a bad thing. But if you're wearing it because it's sort of like she's a hero to you, the way that, you know, kids dress up as Superman, whatever, like, it's just sort of like, maybe that's not a bad thing. I don't know.
Either way, I find it's a form of flattery. If you're gonna make fun of me and dress up as me and bash me, you're still talking about me at the end of the day, so I'm still making the headlines. So thank you, Boo Boo, and thanks for the hate.
There's no bad press kind of situation.
No, there's no bad press. I mean, there's no.
But what
bad
about
press.
Then? What about the Kardashian robbery costume?
Well, okay, that's so offensive. You guys are all gonna judge me. You guys are all gonna
that's
judge
bad.
Me because I was like, "Fuck yes, I want to be that."
It's just
it's
a
iconic.
Robe.
It's still I'll make one at home. Like this is what the world has been talking about for the past, 2-3 weeks now? It's all we hear about. So, if we think about, like, back in the day history stuff, this is going to be part of the history books, you know what I mean? Like, Kim Kardashian, it happened, everyone talks about it.
It'll be in the history books.
It will be, because I'm going to write it.
The JFK assassination. It'll be the
Kim. It will be.
Hold on, though. I think there's a difference between, like, again, intent. Like, if the Caitlyn Jenner one were to be something that was sort of, like, you know, this is a person that I admire or whatever for some reason. I mean, regardless of their, of her transition, Caitlyn Jenner is still awful as a person.
Yeah.
But that's a separate issue. but, you know, like that sort of like, you know, trying to get that out into society of like, this is a hero. The Kim Kardashian Parisian heist thing is sort of monetizing a victim. You know what I mean? And that's sort of like kicking somebody when they're down. It's a bad situation. That's not just, like, you dressing up like Kim Kardashian is awesome, but dressing up like Kim Kardashian in one of the most traumatic events of her life is not necessarily a good thing.
But we're still waiting to see if it was real or not.
Okay.
I mean, of course it was real.
So you think she was in on it?
But why would it not?
Okay.
Why would it not be real? It's not like she
That'll
needs
be another
to
episode.
Do a show.
That'll be another episode.
Yeah. It
was inside
If you guys want to know about my thoughts, just find me on Twitter. We can chat about it. Okay?
That's right. Well, that brings us to our endpoints. Give us all your social media. Where can we find you?
Everything is at Jesse Hazen. So JESSEHAZEN.
Cool.
Yeah,
and any other endpoints? Your bop of the week?
My bop of the week this week is going to be GRL, Kiss Myself. They're back together. There's three girls now. Two of them are the originals, and one of them is Maja's sister.
I actually like GRL.
Maja's sister. They have a new
bop. So don't make fun of me for not knowing certain people. I like GRL.
I know.
It's okay. It's a girl group. Any
girl
other endpoints?
Grill girl.
Well, my endpoint, I'm going to do this again. I'm going to talk about our crowdfunding campaign and Patreon. We want a better set. We want, right? I mean, look, the hat is great, but we need more. Patreon.com.
We need a gown.
And okay, actually, give me Michael. He'll help me with the end of the show.
That's so awkward.
Give me Michael out of your crotch.
I can't handle this.
Okay.
Right
now. If you like us, make sure to give us a thumbs up and subscribe to us on our YouTube channel. Again, our crowdfunding campaign is on Patreon at patreon.com/thepointguys. If you like us, please support us. Also like us on Facebook for all the latest updates on
this
the show.
This
is not okay. And join us next time when we talk about whether Fred stepped over the goddamn line.
Follow us on Twitter and Instagram at ThePointGuys. Our email is ThePointGuys@gmail.com. And for all things The Point, visit our website, ThePointGuys.net. And please, if you do nothing else, share this video with the rest of the world on your social media.
And subscribe.
And subscribe.
And happy Halloween.
Happy Halloween. Happy Halloween. Happy Halloween. You can join us weekly because we have a new show up every Tuesday. So we will
see you next Tuesday
on The Point.